Lithuania was occupied by the USSR from the end of the Second World War and lived under the control of the Kremlin for nearly half a century. So people are especially worried by the threat of a new Russian invasion. In Kaunas, the country's second largest city, Smilte's family attends mass every Sunday at this Catholic church. The practice of religion was forbidden during their childhood, but today Smilte and her husband Rolandas are fervent practitioners. They pray for the end of the war in Ukraine. The conflict has renewed fears of their expansionist Russian neighbor. When they were children, Smilte and Rolandas witnessed family members being deported to Siberia. Lithuania was scarred by the deportation of hundreds of thousands of its citizens during the Soviet occupation. The trauma of this still lives on among its people today.
Melstis į bažnyčią atėjęs atvirai ir kai žinai, kad tai, kas dabar dedasi, sakysim, tu Ukraino už sienos, kad tai yra labai, labai, labai nedaug, labai trapu ir tai gali pasikartoti pas mus.
Ir mes nenorim, kad mūsų vaikai taip gyventų. Dėl to mes turime būti pasiruošę.
On weekdays, Smilte works at a university as the director of communication. On the weekends, she puts on her combat fatigues. About a year ago, she joined the Lithuanian Riflemen's Union, a paramilitary militia. This 43-year-old mother would never have imagined that she would ever be a volunteer fighter.
Iš tikrųjų labai esu patriotiška ir labai myliu savo šalį. Ir iš tikrųjų mes labai gerai prisimenam, kad kaimynai, kurie yra ne taip toli, yra nusiteikę labai grobuoniškai. Nereikia žiūrėti nieką, kad kažkas mus apgins. Tai yra mano pareiga padaryti viską, kad mano vaikai gyventų saugioje šalyje.
Today, Smilte is traveling to Kasiadoris in the west of the country. She will take part in an induction ceremony. A 100 new recruits take the oath. There are men, women, but also young people aged between 11 and 18. The Lithuanian Riflemen have more than 13,000 members, slightly more than the regular army.
Didžiulis susidomėjimas smarkiai padidėjo prasidėjus karui Ukrainoje. Ir jau dabar mūsų rinktinė išdidėjo praktiškai trečdaliu papildomai priimtų daugiau negu 500 naujų šaulių vien po vasario mėnesio.
Recruitment is on the rise, and it is not surprising. According to the commander-in-chief, Albertas Dapkus, the enemy is at the gates.
Na, kaip ir žinote, iš radio, televizijos, spaudos pranešimų, kas vyksta Ukrainoje. O ukrainiečiai neturėjo laiko, jie dabar mokinasi tą koordinaciją, atidirbinėja tuos veiksmus, kur mato reikalinga, o mes turim laiko.
In Ukraine, the defenders have halted the advance of Russian troops. So, having learned the lessons from this war, the Union of Riflemen have created a specialized training program, combat in an urban environment. The next day, 100 men are mobilized for a large-scale military exercise that will push them to their limits. It's not easy to turn civilians into elite fighters. A few minutes before the exercise begins, Captain Savickas gives some final words of advice.
Puldamas, gindamas, visada kažkur polinti. Nebijoti tos, kaip priimsi tą sprendimą. Svarbu, kad nebūtų tos pauzės, bet kuo greičiau veiksmas vyks. O po to jau taktikai ten kažką darysim.
The Lithuanian riflemen are separated into two teams. The first team plays the role of enemy soldiers entrenched in this building. The second team's mission is to neutralize them.
Apeinam tada pro kitą kampą, pro antrą, trečią.
Iš rytų šiaurės. Einam į kelią, einam su manimi.
This is the first time that these men have used weapons of war. They have Swedish machine guns loaded with blanks. But the assault does not go as planned. The group on the front line is already on the ground.
You are lying. If you are lying like me, it means dead. If you are wounded, you are sitting. Dead I should be without the cap. If you are wounded, you're sitting like that.
Despite their best efforts, the trainee soldiers seem to be overwhelmed. They don't know which direction to shoot in. They haven't managed to get inside the building yet, and they are already out of ammunition. This lack of preparation will cost them dearly. Because in urban combat, rationing ammunition is one of the keys to victory. After an hour, the enemy is finally neutralized, but at a great cost. If it was a real battlefield, nearly a third of the militiamen would have been killed. Captain Savickas says that becoming a fighter doesn't happen overnight.
Dar aš jų, kaip sakyt, aš taip dar neleisiu, dar reikia treniruodėje. Nu taip yra, mes dabar aptarinėjom vyro. Tai čia vienas iš epizodų, o kare gali būti didelis epizodus ir numatytai pakankamai dar yra, reiktų dar laiko.
Lithuania is not the only Baltic country which fears Russian invasion.